Good day to all fellow Sierra Leonean. Compliment of the season. I greet you in the name of the Lord. I'm here to talk about taxation, you know, in relation to effective service delivery. And actually, we Sierra Leonean, we are paying our taxes. I'm so impressed. I commend all of us that we are, you know, that are paying our taxes. We are doing a very good work. It is our responsibility as citizens to pay our taxes, you know, because it is that money that the government will use to develop this country. Also, I would like to commend the institutions that are responsible to collect taxes, the National Revenue Authority. They are doing very well in the area of tax mobilization or generation, or in the area of revenue mobilization or revenue generation. In the past 2 years, they have collected huge amount of, you know, revenue that has helped the government greatly in paying civil servants and address some, you know, project implementation. The institution as a whole is doing well. The National Revenue Authority, NRA, they are doing well. Also, we want the government to reciprocate the taxes that we are paying by providing services that are needed by the people. That is why we are paying our taxes. We are paying our taxes, one, because it is our civic responsibility, and also the government should also provide the services that we need. It is the responsibility of the government to provide basic and affordable services that are needed by the people. That is why we are paying our taxes. You know, like presently, if you look at some of the services that are provided by the government, they are not effective and they are not enough. Let's look at it categorically. Let's look at some of the services that are provided by the government. First, let's look in the area of, you know, education. Government is spending a lot of money in the area of this free education, free and quality educational project. Yes, it's true they are spending a lot of money, but like, the quality of the education is lacking. Government should put up mechanism in addressing the area of the educational sector by improving the education. Recently, the people that search for the children that search for the West Africa Senior Secondary School examination, when their result came out, you know, less than 1% have university requirement. It's so unfortunate. You know, it's so shocking. That is an indication that the educational system is lacking some quality aspects. That is an indication that government need to do more by improving the educational system. You know, let's look into the area of electricity supply. They are trying in the area of electricity supply. Yeah, they follow the footsteps of the past government, like that. It's just like continuity. They are trying a lot, even though they need to do more to sustain it. We need sustainable electricity supply. They are trying. But we need sustainable, like in the area where I stay, we have, you know, constant electricity supply, but it's not sustainable. But in certain area of Freetown, they do not have, you know, electricity supply, enough electricity supply. That is an indication that government should do more. Also in the area of the road maintenance, the road construction, they are doing well. I would like to commend the government because they also follow the footsteps of the previous government, and it's just like continuity. They are doing well in that area, in the area of road construction and road maintenance. They are doing well, but they need to do more. They need to do more. Those are some of the services that we the people are expecting from the government. In the area of sufficient water supply, you know, they need to do more. They are trying, but they are not doing better. They need to do more. Like in the area where I'm living in Lemon Lane, like that Mount Duya area, people are suffering for water. We did not have sufficient water supply. If you are fortunate to be in Lemon Lane, you see liter of 5 gallon rubber all over the street. People, you know, are not sleeping in at night to just try to fetch water. People are coming from the hillside, the whole of Mount Oya and some other part of Freetown. People are suffering for water supply. We need pure and sufficient drinking water. That is the responsibility of the government to provide some of those services. That is why we are paying our taxes. Government should try to, you know, address that area of water supply. We need sufficient water supply. People are suffering. Also in the area of health, good health, you know, the government should concentrate in that area. The medical facility in this nation is very, very poor. People are dying as a result of the medical facility in this nation. You know, people are dying with common sickness and disease as a result of the poor medical facility of this nation. You see young girls and women going for child delivery, they will die there. Many people, young girls and women have lost their life doing child delivery as a result of, you know, the poor medical facility. It's so bad. It's so unfortunate. The life expectancy for Sierra Leonean is 37. Many young people are dying as a result of poor medical facility. Government should concentrate in that area. Presently or recently, a lot of young women and girls have lost their life in child delivery. It's so unfortunate. If you are having a person that is pregnant presently, you'll be afraid because the rate of death in child delivery is so alarming. Government should try to put up mechanisms to address that area of, you know, medical facility. That is why we are paying our taxes. It is the responsibility of the government to provide those services, to make those services available to the people of this nation, to the citizens of this nation. You know, also, you know, in the area of infrastructure, we need more infrastructure, especially in this free education. As a result of this free education, many children are going to school now. And we need some infrastructure to accommodate all those children. You know, we need infrastructural development in different sectors in this nation. Government should provide those facilities. You know, yeah, Lord, these are some of just the few services that I believe are pressing. Also, in the area of custom charges, it's a very sensitive part. Presently, we understand that a lot of people are grumbling lot of investors are discouraging as a result of the high cost of charges. Many people, even when they, you know, they import goods from overseas country to here, because of the custom charges, they were not able to, you know, clear those goods. As a result of those charges or those high tax that are normally imposed on investors, as a result of that, most that has, you know, drive away a lot of investors out of the country. And it is the responsibility of the government to provide employment for the citizen of this nation. If you raise the taxes on investors, you will drive them, and that will affect the employment facilities for the people of this nation. Government should try to address that area. Government should try to create an environment for the investors and the body that are responsible for taxation to understand themselves, so that, you know, we have more investors in this country. It is the responsibility of the government, as I said earlier, to provide basic necessities of life of the people of this nation. We need services that are affordable. You know, sometimes you have money, you need certain service, you are not able to have them. It's so unfortunate. You know, government should look in that area. You know, like, let us just compare, like, the informal taxation or informal revenue that are collected by the people in the rural area. In 2017 to 18, I was, you know, was fortunate to undertaking a study with one doctor who is living in Canada. You know, he's a hardworking woman. We learned a lot about informal revenue. You know, people sometimes contribute a lot to provide services that they need in the community. Like, we are fortunate to work in the north and in the east part of Sierra Leone, and we are able to cover three districts, that Koinadugu, Kono and Kailan. In Koinadugu, we are able to cover three chiefdoms. That is, we cover Mongo, Sulema and Kasonko chiefdom. You know, we are able to find out a lot of things about the people of those locality. In Kono, the same, we cover three chiefdoms, and within each chiefdom, we are able to cover, like, you know, three sections. Each section, we are able to cover like 10 to 15 villages. So we went to different villages. We are able to have a lot of information about informal taxation, informal revenue mobilization, how people contributed to provide services that they need. Like in the area of education, some village, they contribute and build schools. You know, they sustain that school. They even pay for community teachers. Teachers that, you know, they are not having PIN code or their name are not on payroll. They even contribute for them and pay, you know, monthly for them. In the area of some of the service, that they even contributed to dig water well and borehole. They even contributed to create, like, church mosques, to build church and mosque, and also dry floor. In the those situations occur in the north, in the east. Both Kailan and Kono also are doing the same thing. So, like, people, you know, sometimes willingly like to, you know, pay informal taxes, because they know when they pay, they will have the services immediately. When they pay, they will have the services that they are paying for, compared to when you pay
a formal tax, or when you pay formal tax to the central government, you did not have in any services as a result of the service that you are paying. Most of them are paying taxes to the local government, they are paying local taxes, but no form of development in those areas. So, you know, government should learn from, you know, the informal taxation. They should try to put up mechanism to address the area of effective service delivery. It is the responsibility of the government to provide quality service for the people of this nation. Services that are affordable. We need, you know, services that are needed by the people of this nation. God bless you. Happy, you know, Christmas in advance.